Children should be able to lead healthy lives no matter who they are, where they live, or how much money their families earn. Yet too many Latino children face challenges to their ability to enjoy good health because they suffer from obesity and hunger more than other children. In 2012, around 40% of Latino children were overweight or obese, compared to about one-third of all children in the U.S. 22% of all Hispanic children are obese, compared to about 17% of other children. To put that in perspective, the number of Hispanic children in the U.S. who are obese is equal to the entire population of Los Angeles. At the same time, Latino children are among the hungriest in America, making up about 30% of children living without enough food to lead active and healthy lives. These issues seem like opposite problems. After all, how are hungry kids becoming obese or overweight? In fact, obesity and hunger are two sides of the same coin. In 2013, almost 5 million Hispanic children lived in households that did not have enough food. Poor nutrition can have lifelong effects on a child's development and quality of life. Hunger can affect obesity, and obese children are more vulnerable to preventable conditions like type 2 diabetes, which can lead to complications into adulthood. Children who are hungry not only face the same risks for obesity as other American children, but they experience additional barriers limiting their access to healthy food. One reason Latino families have difficulty putting food on the table is a tight budget. When not enough money is coming in, families may make painful choices, like cutting back on food, in order to pay for rent or utilities. Another barrier is access. Hispanic neighborhoods have almost one-third fewer chain supermarkets than other areas, leaving many Latinos no other option than to travel far from home to find affordable, nutritious food. There are tools to combat these challenges. Federal nutrition programs, like the school meal program, provide access to nutritious food where children spend a majority of their day. In 2012, about 25% of all children enrolled in these programs were Latino. Other programs like WIC and SNAP are important too because a significant share of enrollees are Latino. Together, these programs are an important source of healthy, affordable food for millions of Americans and must remain strong. Latino childhood obesity and hunger affect us all. Today, one in every four children in the U.S. is Hispanic. Given its projected growth, this population stands to contribute increasingly to our great nation's prosperity. It's important that we address the unique needs of Latino children so they can lead long and healthy lives. We can't let these children become the first generation to have a shorter life expectancy than their parents.